Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, brothers and sisters. This is the session number 11. And in this session, I will be discussing about one of the most important matters that a Muslim should know, which is about the Qadr. And in this part of the Qadr, I will be discussing about the ajal of a person. People, especially in this time that we are living in, with the existence of this pandemic and so many other things, you know, the fear of death, you know, is so much. Is it wrong to be afraid of death? No, it is wrong. It is not wrong, because it is part of our nature. But it shouldn't go beyond limit in the way you think that there is a way for you to avoid it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَيْنَمَا تَكُونُوا يُدْرِكُمُ الْمَوْتُ وَلَوْ كُنْتُمْ فِي بُرُوجٍ مُشَيِّدًا. As a Muslim, you should take all the precautions to make sure that you protect yourself by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from anything that can put you into trouble. That's what we do. But at the same time, as a Muslim, you should have the belief that the time that is written for you by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever this time is arrived, you have to live this life. And that might be the reason why one of the great companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was reported to have said, "Utlubul mauta tuhabulakum al-haya." Look for death, and life should be given to you. And dear brothers and sisters, don't misunderstand. I'm not talking about you staying away from medication. No, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Tadawwu ibadallah." Look for medicine, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and that means it is permissible. It is part of our Sharia that when a person is sick, he should look for the medicine. But when the iman is on the medicine itself, you believe that the medicine is the one that is acting in terms of protecting you in a way. If you don't take it, you will die. Or if you take it, you will never die. This is affecting your iman with the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concerning the ajal. There were a group of people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk about them in a very brief manner in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Baqarah. He says, أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ خَرَجُوا مِنْ دِيَارِهِمْ وَهُمْ أُلُوفٌ حَذَرَ الْمَوْتِ فَقَالَ لَهُمُ اللَّهُ مُوتُ ثُمَّ أَحْيَاهُمْ. These people, they went out of their city. حَذَرَ الْمَوْتِ. They are afraid of death, you know. And they were not supposed to go out. So they ran away out of the fear of death. فَقَالَ لَهُمُ اللَّهُ مُوتُ ثُمَّ أَحْيَاهُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell them, die. And they died, all of them. ثُمَّ أَحْيَاهُمْ. And then he brought them back. Show them that this is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many times we have heard, you know, we heard about a person who is confirmed by the medical doctors that he will be living this life, or his days are numbered, and he lived. Because life is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why I take it as a joke, somebody to tell you that if you take this type of food, if you eat this and that, you will live longer. No, this is always made by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We eat good, we eat healthy things, we take medicine to try to reach a very comfortable life, but at the same time, as a Muslim, you should have the faith and the belief that life and death are controlled by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the one who decides when this person is leaving and when this person is leaving. So Muslims should believe in this, that life and death is held by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and only when your time arrives, you will die. If the time did not arrive, wallahi, you will not die, no matter how much difficult is the situation. I will repeat my word, my dear brothers and sisters. I'm not saying medication is wrong. Medication is absolutely correct and part of our religion if a person is taking the halal one, but it shouldn't affect your qadr in the way you are thinking that this is the thing that is protecting you. And we have heard about vaccination that are coming, as if, you know, this is the ultimate protection everyone has. No, the ultimate protection we have is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of these are causes. And the Khaliq al-Sabab wal-Musabab is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one who created the cause and the effect is Allah. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wish, you might take something which you think is a medicine for you, but it will be the reason why you will leave this life. So we need the support from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is actually the essence of my speech. I just want you to maintain your tawakkul on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the belief that life and death are in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're just using the asbab to avoid getting into trouble of a sickness, but at the same time we believe that the one who is making it works, whatever we are doing, the one who is making it works and also the one who is activating it, the one who is making it effective is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If he doesn't want it to be effective, it will never work. We all know that the medication nowadays we are taking, it is based on this. Sometimes I take a medicine, you know, due to an illness, which you have the same thing also. You took the medicine, the same medicine I'm taking, you are okay and I'm not okay. Why it works with you and it doesn't work with me? There has to be something which is there which we might not know the reason why it doesn't work with me, but it works with you. But on top of all, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed that this is not going to work at this moment. So what am I going to do? Am I supposed not to use the medicine and stay home? No. The Prophet said, just do. Because we did not know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed. What is our job is to maintain our iman that everything is controlled by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا يَكُونُ فِي مُلْكِهِ إِلَّا مَا يُرِيدُ. As a Muslim, whatever I'm doing, I'm looking for rizq, but I know that the barakah is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If he removes it, I will never get anything. I struggle, I fight for the rizq, you know. This is what the Prophet advised me to do. But at the same time, I have the faith that whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for me will never escape me. And I cannot get more than that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written to me. But at the same time, also the Prophet asked me not to be lazy. To be engaging in that which benefits me and my life. So my point here, my dear brothers and sisters, is to keep this iman with you that life and death are held by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he's the one who controls it. So we use medicine out of the hope and the tawakkul on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, complete tawakkul on Allah. I use the medicine, but I have to make sure that iman with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being the only one who will give ability to the medicine to work, you know, is always there in my heart. So on top of all, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who is giving everything possibility and ability to act in the way it should be doing. So this iman has to be maintained in our heart. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you a good life and ease all of your affairs. Innahu bi kulli jameelin kafeel. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.